This right here is a lesser electric ray, and its genus species name is Narcine bancrofti. Blacktail moray eel, Gymnothorax pulpos. This is called a sooty eel, Bascanichthys bascanium. I actually collected this one off the beach. It burrows in the straight down into the sand. Stuck its head up, I grabbed it and started pulling, and it just kept coming up and up and up. Should I put this down?
Probably.
I've been working for Texas Parks and Wildlife for 33 and a half years. I got a call from somebody at our Seabrook office, and he said, "Do you know your fish?" I said, "Well, yeah, I know them very well." He says, "Do you know how to run a boat?" I said, "Yes, I do." He said, "Can you start Monday?" I was like, "Sure." And I hung up and I thought, I don't even know where Seabrook is. I don't know what I've just done. But that was my interview for this position, and I've been in it ever since.
Brenda is very knowledgeable about identifying marine species. She's very well known for that. A lot of people rely on those skills to identify various species that we're not sure what they are.
Can't make good management decisions to protect the natural resources unless we know what we have out in the water. When we go out to sample, you have to know what it is that you're collecting in that gear.
That's a great barracuda. That is an alligator gar, southern flounder, bluefish, black drum, blunt-nosed jack, hyphen goby, hog choker, leather jack, sheep's head minnow, moonfish, pigfish, henfish, ladyfish, sea cucumbers. Most people don't care what kind it is. I do. If I get a critter, I don't stop until I get it down to genus and species. Around 2004, I was trying to get everybody to identify what we have correctly because that makes our data so much better.
And she came up with some ideas to take pictures of dead fish. And then she moved from there to, well, let's make it a field guide for the staff to share. And she, you know, pulled pictures together and was like, let's take it a step further. So about 5 years, she had built up about 500 pictures.
I had too much to put in a book. So I decided maybe a website would be best. I got a book on the internet and I looked up how to build a website.
It's been a very useful tool for not only people within the division, but people in the public. In fact, all across the country, go to her website to find out about fish.
And so she's really provided more than just a tool for the agency and for the staff, but she's provided a wonderful outreach component. And it's just, it's been a lot of work on her part. And no one said, you've got to do this. It was something she's passionate about and something that she worked for.
I enjoy sharing that information with not only our people, with the public, and they really seem to appreciate it. So I will continue this even after I retire, because I'm never going to stop.